Hi, I'm Probate Judge Deborah Anderson. I'd like to thank you for your interest in the Teen Victim Impact Program. You're about to take the first step in protecting your teenage drivers. As a parent of a teen driver, my number one priority was the safety of my child. Unfortunately, in this day and age of technology, our teenage drivers are faced with additional distractions that are causing our roadways to be more dangerous. By partnering with the Teen Victim Impact Program, our goal is to reduce teen traffic violations that contribute to teen deaths caused by car crashes. We target teens because for their age group, they have the highest fatality rate. However, the things discussed in this program apply to everyone. Anyone who attends one of our programs will learn how to be a better driver and even a better passenger.
My mate Jules fancies
Please
you.
Pass.
It's not a free call.
It's not even funny now.
Oh, let me just get his number.
Stay still. I can't open the door. Just, I've rung an ambulance.
We've got other people on the route to help, okay?
Three vehicles have been involved. Two people in the vehicle there. I can't get any response out of them whatsoever. Mommy, Daddy, wake up. Mommy, Daddy, wake up. I just can't get any response whatsoever. I want Mommy and Daddy to wake up.
Any pain in your neck at all?
You're nice and still for me. Alright, keep looking at me.
Alright.
Cassie,
can you hear me? What's your friend's name in the back?
What is it?
Jules, is it?
No, she's still there for me. She's
I'm Gary Gullidge. As your sheriff, I'm urging you to bring your teen drivers and soon-to-be teen drivers to one of these programs offered in Paulding County. We need to get rid of the "it won't happen to me" mindset. It makes no difference who you are, what color your skin is, what your religion is, or how much your family income is. It makes no difference if you excel in sports and academics, or if you're a troublemaker and flunking school. The only common denominators in these fatal crashes are the decisions and choices made by individuals in the car. One of those fatal decisions is not wearing a seatbelt. We need to instill the necessity of wearing seatbelts while in a vehicle. Many of the teens that you will hear about in this program would be alive today if they had worn their seatbelts.
This is Michael. Today he's going to hit his girlfriend so hard, she ends up with permanent brain damage.
Three dead in this vehicle. The girl is critical. They say the guy without the seatbelt did the damage.
No seatbelt, no excuse.
We lose on average 6,000 teens per year in car crashes, and that equates to one every 90 minutes or half a classroom per day. Protect your family, talk to your children about the dangers of distracted driving and the importance of seatbelt use. Help us eliminate teen driving error.
Time it is?
Yeah.
Have fun?
A little bit past 11:20.
Good. Oh crap, I need to get home.
Shotgun.
Seriously, my parents are going to kill me.
Thanks for giving us a ride.
Okay, thanks so much for taking us home.
Come on.
Yeah.
Oh, don't worry.
Hey, you guys.
Yeah, Matt left us. Guys. Imagine that.
There's not enough room for all of us.
Yeah, there's way too many people, you guys.
Who cares? Well, wait, that's my curfew.
You can sit on my lap.
Okay.
Yeah, I know you want to.
Right.
Pilot,
get in, baby.
Go!
You guys, there aren't enough seatbelts.
Right in the middle.
Jessica, sit on James' lap. We'll be fine.
There's nothing.
What? What?
You did it!
Oh, okay.
Seriously, though.
Come on, go faster.
Seriously, you're driving like my grandma.
Yeah.
You see the pedal next to the brake? That's the accelerator. Maybe you should.
You could.
Yeah,
come on. Yeah.
Ashton, you shall
even the best
see.
Driver.
You're fine. You're fine.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
Guys, that's Aiden, way too fast. Why don't we just throw James out of the car and he can walk home?
Yeah, who cares about
him? Who can vote at all?
Who cares about James?
Yeah.
Just kidding.
No, I need to get home.
Okay, do you realize that if he goes faster and gets pulled over, then you're going to be extra late?
But then I'll have a good excuse.
What?
I did have
no hitch!
Oh my god! That was sweet!
You're like a maniac. It's so
look,
sweet.
Look! No, no, look that way!
Oh my god!
See, now no, first we set the cruise control. See? Knee up.
What are you doing?
Thank you.
connected on a fatal accident at Ken Carroll at Continental in Jefferson County. Three teenagers are dead, several other people hurt.
Begins to raise his voice, you lower yours, grant him one last choice, drive until you lose the road, a break with the ones you follow. He will do one of two things, he will admit to everything, or he'll say he's just not the same, and you'll be.
The driver of the Chevy is 16 years old, and the last report she was in serious condition at Swedish Medical Center. Under state law, drivers her age are only supposed to have one passenger in the front, and everybody in the car must wear seat belts.
Most people do not realize that less than 25% of teen deaths are attributed to drinking and driving. Cell phones and texting are surpassing alcohol as a major cause of accidents and deaths on our roadways. Our children are only 20% of our population, but they are 100% of our future. Together we can make a positive difference, and by working together, keep them safe. Please look online for the next available class.